The Philippine Education Department is looking for teachers to conduct classes on radio and television when a new school year begins on August 24. Let's talk to Education Undersecretary for Curriculum and Instruction, Diosdado San Antonio, for more on this. Good morning, Yusek, and thank you so much for taking our call.
Good morning.
Yusek, good morning. What's the latest on the initiative? Have many been hired so far, and the qualifications? Can you also please advise us on this?
The Department of Education has made a call, and we are now in the process of identifying them. Mm-hmm. We are guided by professional support from professional TV broadcasters. Mm-hmm. So we are confident that we have set the right standards. Mm-hmm. And they will be really trained by professionals. Mm-hmm. And we are very confident that out of the 900,000 teachers, we will find our talents for providing TV-based instruction.
Mm-hmm. So far, sir, how many has sent their requests, their audition
Unfortunately,
tapes?
I don't have the exact numbers with me, but I understand we have met the expected numbers. And even the expected numbers, as I speak now, I failed to provide myself with the exact numbers, but they would be enough to make us produce the episodes we would need for the delivery of distance learning via TV and radio.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. Yusek, of course, moving forward, recorded classes will be more feasible than doing live classes on air. Who will be responsible for recording and editing classes for uniformity and also checking for quality assurances?
As I've said, we are being supported by professional broadcasters and talent managers relative to TV broadcast. We will hopefully do it within our own means and facilities. But yes, they will be recorded and they will be farmed out to the channels that will be taking part in our effort to provide TV-based instruction.
Mm-hmm. But sir, on your on previous interviews, you've mentioned it has been mentioned that teachers who are willing to apply should have at least basic skills in editing and recording. Will they be the ones responsible to edit and record their own videos, or will DepEd have their own editing team to do everything?
The fact is, we have teachers who know how to do this. In our National Schools Press Conference, we have events or competitions for TV broadcasting. Mm-hmm. But of course, that was like for news and like a production of a certain news program. Mm-hmm. This time it's going to be the production of lessons. So I think the technical aspects would not be hard to learn, considering that even previous to COVID-19, our fellow teachers, some of them, those who really have been trained, are able to coach the students. Yes, as I've said, we'll not really start from zero. Mm-hmm. We're starting from the existing pool of talents that we have among our fellow teachers in the Department of Education.
Yusek, how will audio classes happen? Is the government technically equipped to make this work come August 24?
In terms of TV,
TV and radio,
this would be for all the distance learning delivery modalities. As envisioned, we are offering options. We are not prescribing a specific distance learning delivery modality for for everybody. Mm-hmm. The Secretary of Education, Secretary Liling Briones, has been very clear that decisions on specific distance learning delivery modality should be made at the field level. The schools, the division offices, and the regional offices have been able to demonstrate that they're capable of doing this. Mm-hmm. In terms of TV, there would be like a suggested centralized schedule for certain grades. Mm-hmm. We may not be able to provide for all grades and all learning areas, considering constraints of time and programming. Mm-hmm. But we had to identify the learning areas that would most be like appropriate for TV-based instruction.
Yusek, you are saying right now that TV and radio classes are just an option for our schools. Does this mean that if this is just an option, a grading system for TV and radio classes will not happen? Will it still depend on the school themselves?
As of course, when we say option, they are among the options that the learners could have. Mm-hmm. And of course, the general option is still the use of printed mm-hmm. modules. And again, because we say it could be blended with other distance learning delivery modalities, mm-hmm. one who uses a distance a printed self-learning module may mm-hmm. may decide to also monitor what's happening on TV and radio, so that they can further understand the lessons being taught for mm-hmm. the week. Mm-hmm. So we would still expect the kids to do exercises, worksheets, mm-hmm. Learning activity sheets to demonstrate that they are learning, regardless of the distance learning delivery modality. And that would include TV and radio-based instruction. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. So teachers would really have a way of monitoring and determining whether the children are learning.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Lastly, you said before I let you go, when it comes to questions, real-time questions by students with regard to classes given on TV and radio classes, will this be submitted to teachers instead, and will they be getting back to students? Because, of course, it will not be able to happen real-time. How are we addressing this, sir?
We understand that communication is a very important aspect mm-hmm. that has to be addressed for mm-hmm. distance learning to be very effective. Mm-hmm. And we expect, and we've been emphasizing this with our fellow teachers, mm-hmm. that they have to find a way to be able to connect with the families. Mm-hmm. It's essentially, I think, knowing that the Philippines has like a pervasive use of mobile phones, communications may be done through text messaging, or perhaps those with access to mm-hmm. Facebook, FB Messenger, or other social media opportunities. As demonstrated in the current dry runs going on, the teachers have been very creative. Mm-hmm. They've been able to really connect and communicate with families. Mm-hmm. And so if there are really doubts on the concepts being learned, we feel that the learners will be able mm-hmm. to do this through preferably, as I've said, mobile phones, but mm-hmm. they are also expected to hand in the accomplished activity sheets mm-hmm. at the end of each week.
Mm-hmm. All right, with that, I will let you go. Thank you so much for your time, Yusek Diosdado San Antonio. Thank you, sir, and good morning.
Thank you very much. God bless.